What happens when PVA glue is mixed with sugar? It might sound ridiculous. Many people would assume that this mixture is completely useless. But today, I'm going to show you an incredible idea from this simple combination, something very few people know about, and the result will truly surprise you. For the first step, prepare two clean empty containers. Pour PVA glue into one of them, adjusting the amount based on your needs. Next, add a spoonful of sugar into the other container. Dissolve the sugar with warm water. You can actually use regular water, but warm water helps the sugar dissolve much faster. You can stir the sugar solution to speed up the dissolving process. It's important to note that both sugar and PVA glue share the same characteristic. They easily mix with water, and that's exactly the property we're going to take advantage of. Once the sugar has completely dissolved, pour both liquids into a single container. The mixture will appear mostly white due to the PVA glue. Next, prepare some cement powder and slowly add it into the mixture while stirring until it starts to thicken. Which city or country are you watching this video from? Leave a comment. I'd love to know how far this content has reached across the world. It's amazing to know that we can stay connected no matter where we are in the world. Stir the mixture thoroughly until it's completely smooth, making sure there are no lumps of cement so the result can be used effectively. Next, I added some coloring to the mixture. You can adjust it to match your preferred color. Connect three cable ties together to form a circular shape in the center. This will serve as the foundation for the simple mixing tool we're about to create. Take a small wooden stick and insert it through the center of the cable tie ring, tightening it firmly to keep it secure. Trim the ends of the cable ties so the propeller blades aren't too long. Now, you've got a simple electric mixer that can be used with a drill. Mixing with this tool provides a much smoother and more consistent result compared to manual stirring. But if you don't have a drill, you can still mix it by hand. Just make sure to stir thoroughly so all the ingredients blend perfectly, giving you an impressive final result. The final mixture takes on the same color as the base pigment you added, though it appears slightly lighter. It may look like regular paint, but it's not your typical paint. This mixture can be used on a variety of surfaces. The sugar water helps create a denser texture when the cement is applied, while the PVA glue acts as a protective layer, making the coating more durable and long-lasting. The cement increases the volume of the mixture, so you only need a small amount of pigment to achieve your desired color. You can apply this mixture to concrete floors in your yard. Concrete surfaces, which usually look dull and plain, will appear much more aesthetic without needing a large amount of pigment, as the cement in the mixture helps extend the color coverage. You can also apply it on wooden surfaces. This paint won't fade easily because it's protected by a PVA-based coating that resists scratches, sunlight, and even rainwater. Once it's fully dry, the result looks excellent, durable, vibrant, and gives the surface a more appealing and refined look. Next, I'm going to show you another amazing idea that can be really useful for you. Prepare an empty container and pour some gasoline into it. Adjust the amount according to your needs. Then, add some cement powder into the container with gasoline. Normally, cement is mixed with water, but in this video, I'll show you something different. A method that will truly surprise you with the result. Add a few spoonfuls of cement into the container filled with gasoline, then stir until the texture turns into a paste, similar to when you mix cement with water. Next, prepare another material that's very easy to find and often considered waste, styrofoam. Add small pieces of styrofoam into the container containing the cement and gasoline mixture. As soon as it's added, the styrofoam will start to dissolve immediately, since gasoline acts as a powerful solvent that can easily break down styrofoam. Gradually add more styrofoam until the mixture thickens in texture. A quick safety reminder, never perform this step while smoking, as gasoline is highly flammable. Always prioritize safety in everything you do. By combining knowledge, creativity, and a careful approach, the results of your work will be far more impressive and satisfying. Once the mixture thickens and blends completely, you can now see the result, something you may have seen before but never knew how it was made. If you recognize what it is, feel free to share your thoughts in the comments. This is a simple yet remarkable creation that can make your everyday tasks easier, using only materials that are easily available around you. Here, I have a section of the roof that has developed a hole. Instead of replacing it or buying a new one, this amazing mixture can be used to repair the damaged area. Simply apply some insulation underneath, then pour a small amount of the mixture into the hole until it spreads evenly. This simple method works not only for clay roof tiles, but also for metal and asbestos sheets, making it a versatile solution for different types of roofing. Next, I have a plastic bucket that's already cracked. Although plastic buckets are quite inexpensive, instead of buying a new one, you can easily repair it using this amazing mixture. The repair process is very simple. First, clean the damaged area and sand the surface so the mixture can adhere properly. Before applying it, cover the inside of the hole with some tape to prevent the mixture from leaking through. Then, gently pour the mixture over the cracked area until it's completely sealed and evenly covered. This repair method can easily be done on your own without needing anyone's help. It's a simple and effective way to save money, since you don't have to buy new items every time something breaks at home. Just use this mixture to fix cracked or broken items effortlessly. For the best results, let the repaired area sit for 24 hours to allow the mixture to harden completely, ensuring a stronger and more durable finish. After letting it sit for 24 hours, it's time to test the strength of this mixture. It has hardened perfectly and adheres strongly to both plastic and other surfaces. To test its durability, I'll fill the bucket with water to see if the mixture can withstand the water pressure without any leaks. If you haven't subscribed to this channel yet, make sure to hit the subscribe button now. Join us, as we'll continue sharing many more amazing and creative ideas with you. Take a look at the result. This mixture perfectly withstands water pressure. There's absolutely no leakage, which shows that the repair is firmly sealed. Truly impressive. If you found this video helpful, don't forget to hit the like button. Your support motivates us to keep bringing you more amazing ideas. Share this tip with your friends or family. It might be something useful for them in the future. Thank you for taking the time to watch this video. I hope you found it helpful, and see you in the next video.